and good evening, everyone, and welcome to day two of the Canadian Senior Broomball Championships, coming to you live from the Bayshore Community Center in Owen Sound. I'm Rob Leonard. I'll be your play-by-play announcer for tonight. And with me, Bill Nickel, the expert color commentary.
Slow down on the expert.
Well, you probably know a bit more than I do. So.
I've been around. My mom's been playing. Well, she's still playing. She's 53 years old, and she's been playing. Well, I was well into my diapers when she was playing at first, so she's been around, so it's a lot of family traditions coming around. So.
Awesome. Okay, and there's been some great action here over the last, first 2 days of the tournament, and great games coming up tonight.
Yep.
Games with a lot of meaning in the elite men's division.
Yeah, it's still kind of up in the air for a lot of these teams for position. Three strong men's team, or should say six strong men's team, three strong games, but the Aces, they've been alone up front. I've seen them play a few times, and they're dominant. They're fast, they're quick. We've seen that against Ottawa Nationals, and to be beating the Ottawa Nationals by one goal is incredible. To have them beat them by two goals is just unheard of. So Ottawa is looking to bounce back. They had a tough go today, but I think the Aces are one of the top ones to beat. But right next to us, we got the Sphinx, and the Sphinx, they've been shining too. So the Quebec teams are coming in strong, that's for sure.
And looking at the number three spot with the Palmerston rookies, they were last year's champions, the defending champions coming in, and they started off a little slow. Their only loss was in their first game.
Yep.
Now they've run off three straight wins, so they very well are getting themselves prepared for a run when the playoffs start tomorrow.
Oh, yes, yeah, for sure. And their big win last night in double overtime against the host Kilsyth Phantoms. Like, hometown advantage. Everybody was here to cheer on the Phantoms, but it was a great game. Palmerston took it to them, and they got a pretty good goal in overtime. So don't count anybody out. Still up in the air.
Absolutely. Two great games two out of the three games that I saw last night. Great games. As you said, Kilsyth falling in double overtime in that game. But again, a great game. It was seesaw battle all the way through.
Yep.
You know, it took a long time to decide that. But then the second game with the Quebec Aces playing, as you said, and beating Ottawa by a score of 2-0.
Yeah.
That was a different game in itself. Again, the young Quebec team showing the speed that they've got.
Yes.
And well-organized plays. But again, that speed that they had going down the wings was just incredible. And that really threw the Ottawa team off in my estimation.
Yes, Ottawa is big and strong, and if you're quick enough, you can get away from the strong. But Ottawa knows their mistakes, and they will capitalize. Very rarely would you ever see them have a two bad game. But
I would imagine too, in where the two teams are located, you probably see each other.
Know each other. Ottawa actually had a pretty close game today. They actually fell to the, I think it was the, it wasn't the Sphinx, but I can't remember who it was. But there was another Quebec team that they fell victim to today, but it was a very close game. So.
Okay, so game one tonight. We got three games on tap for you tonight on Rogers. We want to welcome everybody that's watching on Rogers Channel 53, Gray County, and to all of you that are watching on the World Wide Web on the Rogers YouTube channel. Thank you very much for joining us tonight, and we certainly hope you enjoy the action. It's certainly going to be a great night tonight, for sure, with teams battling for the playoff spots. A couple of, as I said, we got three really good games that mean something here tonight.
Yeah, each one holds importance to everything. I know the Sphinx are, they want to compete, and they want to stay in the sack, and the Bisons are coming up strong. They're a little behind, and they've always been the underdog, but I've seen them play, and they're strong, and they're just as quick. So.
All right, looks like the teams have done their cheers, and they're going to get their practice balls off of the ice surface, and we're going to get this game underway. And the Manitoba Bisons will be coming at you from the right of your screen in the dark uniforms, and the Quebec Sphinx in the orange and white jerseys coming at you from the left of your screen. Getting ready for the face-off now at center. The looks like number 15, Darren Korf, is going to be taking the face off against number 87, Bobby Rouleau-Bilodeau.
It's a tongue-tie, some of these names.
And sorry, go ahead.
No, I had to announce some of the MVPs at the rec center, and yeah, you just mumble some of them.
So. I know exactly what you mean. Some of you just fake your way through.
Yeah,
it, right?
Yeah.
All right, action underway here, and scramble going along the boards here. Now picked up by number 69, that's Boulin. Boulin moves it in over the line, into the corner. Boulin now setting up, waiting for his teammates to get into position. Boulin being watched by two players right now. Sets it back now to number 11, that's Sebastian Moise. Moise is going to take a run down the boards with it. Moise tries it out front. Ball's cleared away. That was Joey Ponsack getting it out of harm's way. Now on to number 87. That's Bilodeau. Bilodeau taking his time now. Team waiting for his line mates to make a change. Setting up now in his own zone, waiting for everybody to get into position. Ball is cleared, but not out. Here goes the number 12. Takes a shot into the corner. In the corner now, working it around, looking for somebody, putting it out front, and taken away by the Sphinx, and Sphinx are going to work the ball down, and he's knocked down on that play, but the ball is deep into the Bison zone. Bison's now coming into their own zone with it. That's number 12, that's Ribadeau. Ribadeau gets it out, heading up the center, now on to number 5, that's... Now he's getting around his man, unable to get through. Ball cut off there by number 20, Levine. Levine gets the ball onto Simon Forrest. And now back comes Manitoba. Manitoba working their way into the zone. Here comes a shot and a good save by the goalkeeper. And trying to get the ball out now, kept in by the Bison. Bison now taking their time. Working the ball around, that's number 12, Reg Robideau. Robideau waiting for his teammates to come out on a change. Robideau waiting. Ball comes now over to the far side to Boxall, Wayne Boxall. Goes now over to the far side and it's cleared out and cut off at center.
Bison's controlling the zone most of the time. Sphinx are being a little too relaxed right now, just waiting for their shots, but you can't take too many chances. They'll cough up a mistake and you got to capitalize on it.
Now Sphinx take control of the ball behind their own goal. That's under number 71. Bisson plays it out. Now they're going to satisfy to go back in their own zone and set up again. Working their way out of the zone, the ball is cleared down. Not going fast enough for icing down there. Picked up by the Bisons. Bisons, that's number 10, Boxall. Boxall plays it on now to number 8. That's Ponsack. Ponsack clears it in to the Sphinx zone. Sphinx pick it up. That's Maxime Zanth. Plays the ball out on the other side. It's cleared long. Deep down into the Bison zone. Cleared out of harm's way. Now on to number 15, Darren Korf. Korf now behind his own goal with it. And behind the net to number 8, Joey Ponchak. Ponchak now on to 14, that's Graham Gauthier. Gauthier now gets it in, down the side, number 13. Comes in front, oh, and a great defensive play there by number 55, yep. Bernard Peltier.
He read the guy coming in streaking wide, so he decided just to take the pass away.
And that's going to be called icing.
It's close.
Sphinx players don't like it.
I would have waved it off if I was a ref, because in order for that icing to be complete, the Bisons players have to completely run after that ball. They can't stop and wait for that ball to cross. If they, as soon as they change track or they give up running, then that icing should be waved off.
Okay, the faceoff coming deep in the Sphinx zone. 13:59 remaining in the first period. From the draws, one by Sphinx. Sphinx in behind their own goal. That's number 7, Gabriel Paquin. Paquin gets it out to number 88. That's Richard Rake. Ball now into the zone. There's number 5. That's Simon Forrest. comes out front. Here's a shot. Oh, what a save. Great save by Bryce Manzunga in the goal for the Bisons.
It's a good job for that D just to clear the path for the goalie to see it all, because that ball likes to bounce and it'll bounce off everything.
Sphinx now working the ball around. Comes over to number 91. That's Eve Martineau. Martineau taking his time now. Plays it over to number 7. That's Gabriel Pequin. Pequin takes a look around. Now he's going to try one. Ball's coming in, and the goalkeeper's going to hold on to that one for a face-off.
Good action from both. Oh, here, some guys don't like each other already. It's a long, long game yet, boys. Slow down.
Don't want to be getting into fights in this environment either.
No, not over petty stuff.
Like you said, still lots of game to be played yet. Got some quite a bit at stake here tonight. Face-off now in the zone. Ball comes back in. Bisons take over behind their own goal. Ball left behind the goal. Here comes number 8. That's Ponczak. Ponczak is going to clear it up high. Taken over by Sphinx in their own zone. Ball now played out into the middle, now over to the left side. Sphinx now trying to find some space. The ball's loose. Here it comes through. Shot. Ball goes up over the net. That was number 11, Sebastian Moyes. Good opportunity there by the Sphinx, but unable to capitalize.
The Sphinx are getting most of their shots through. Either it's over the net, but any bounce or anything like that would go in.
Sebastian Moyes plays it into the corner now. It's cut off by Dusty Gudeski. Gudeski trying to come out of his own zone. Plays it up high into the Sphinx zone. Cut off there by number 20, Francois Levine. Back to Levine. Levine plays it. Nice play up into the middle. Good one-touch passing here. Ball now is going to be cleared right back to the goalkeeper, and he's going to cover that up for a face-off.
Oh, good job for the forwards to be forechecking. Get that face-off in their zone. Set up again. Quick passes by the Sphinx in the neutral zone just to get it out. You notice a lot of the times because they just got the one line to get across and it's almost standstill. Just flip it over and chase. We've seen a lot of that last night.
From the draw, ball comes back. Shot hits a player into the mesh. We'll see where the referee is going to place this one.
Didn't look like it hit anybody, so it should be out.
And it's going to come back closest to the Sphinx end. And as you said, for maybe some people that aren't familiar with broomball, these blue lines that are used for hockey really have no impact on this game at all.
So. The only time the blue lines are actually used is the definition of what zone. It's still called the neutral zone between the blue lines, because for hand passes, you can hand pass in your blue line, but if it's outside the blue line, it can be called dead. That would be the only time the blue lines ever come into place.
And the only offsides are... obviously on the red line.
On the red line, yeah.
Right. Now here come the Bisons. Bisons now on the attack. Heading down the wing. That's number 6. That's Dave Kennedy. Kennedy tries one, and it's cleared out of harm's way again. Over to number 69. That's Philippe Boutin. Ball comes back around to the other side. That's number 50, Maxime Xanth. Xanth plays it back to his defense partner. Now... Bison's doing a good job at hemming them into their own zone. No choice but to just clear it high and out. Comes back to the goalkeeper. On now to number 12. That's Reg Robideau. Robideau now on to Ouellette. Ouellette, nice play forward. He's in alone. So what a save. Wow, what a great save by Bert Stacey.
He had him beat, but got the glove up. Nice play from the defense to see the streaking forward on the breakaway.
There's one for the highlight reels. Just gets the hand up there and able to make a great save to keep it a nothing score here. Ball now on to number 50. That's Xanth. Xanth plays it on now to Pequin. Pequin is being hemmed into his own zone. Finally able to get it out. Comes over now to number 12. That's Reg Robideau. Robideau is content to go back to his own end. Ball comes now into the neutral zone, on to number 5. That's Simon Forrest.
Way offside.
Referee blows it down.
Way offside.
Yeah, we're going to take a look at a replay here. Want to walk us through that, Bill?
Yeah, he sees there's no defender there, so he can easily cross the line, which is key because now you got the hole in. But he sees everyone's looking at him at the red line, doesn't see the guy streaking. But the goalie got the upper hand on that one, literally. So
lucky he got that hand up there, absolutely. Here comes a shot. Hits the defender in the backside. That was Dusty Grudeski getting his back in the way there. Sphinx now with some pressure, trying to put it out front. Still got control of it in the end. Taking a look. Here comes a shot. Score! He scores. A little argument here on the part of the Bisons. Maybe some goalkeeper interference. Or...
they're arguing it, yeah. I think it was close to call.
And that goal is going to stand. I don't think they're going to...
it's a good shot. It was a hell of a shot, but they're worried about the guy running right into the crease here.
As you can see, we'll take a look here on the replay. And that was number 11. That was, Sebastian Moise, who was the one that scored the goal here. And you can see where the Sphinx player did trip over the goalkeeper, but
yeah.
I don't know if it would be necessarily goalkeeper interference.
It was pressured into the end, but I've seen a lot worse this tournament. So.
There's the ball cleared deep into the zone, now cut off by the Sphinx defender. Referee's going to call it. Might be offside.
Yep, offside. Just got held up. The Bisons did a good job of checking him on the line there and kept him from going over.
Here's the draw. Number 15 in there is Darren Korf. Korf loses the draw. Looks like Korf and number 69, Boulin, are having words here over the last sequences of play. So. And there's a bit of a hit laid on. Now here come the Bisons. Bisons coming into the zone, working the ball around, playing it back now to number 11. That's James Nolan. Nolan's going to play it into the zone, cut off. Now here comes the Sphinx. Got a two-on-two shaping up here. It's number 69, Boulin. Boulin tries one. Good save by goalkeeper. That's number 30 in there, Bryce Mazuga. Comes back out front. Here's another chance. Oh, he couldn't get the handle on that one. And now here come the Bisons. Bisons trying to make a run up. Cut off at the line. There's number 91, Marino. Marino plays it off the boards now down to number 69. Boulin back to Marino. Marino plays it over to number 7. That's Pequin. Shot. Another save by the Bisons goalkeeper. Ball now. Working out in front, dangerously out in front of their own goal. Here's a ball up high, number 7. For the Bisons, he's just going to let that one go.
Well, someone, I think one of the Sphinx yelled offside, but he thought it was the ref. It's the
always play until you hear the whistle. And here comes Sphinx again. Shot, score! What a shot by number 88. That was Jonathan Richard Rake. Wow.
Yeah, that was quite a ball right off the post. And then goalie came out and tried to challenge it a bit, but he didn't get all the angles.
And on the first goal, it was by number 20, Francois Levine, at 9:36. That was on the first Sphinx goal. And we'll take a look on the replay here. Got a head of speed coming in there, just a perfectly placed shot right off the post and in.
Yep.
Goalkeeper's not stopping that one.
No. It's just snuck right by him.
Now here come the Bisons again, trying to work their way in. Comes out now to number 5, that's Joel Robidoux. Robidoux gets around one defender, ball comes into the area. On to number 7, that's Dallas Ouellette. Ouellette takes a swing at it. Ball comes into the corner, Sphinx pick it up. Sphinx sitting in second place right now with a record of 4-1. I believe that's what it was, 4-1.
Yeah.
And we've got the official scoring on the second goal. Number 88, Jonathan Richard Rake. Richard Rake scores from number 91, Jan Marino, at 7:54 to give Sphinx a 2-0 lead on a beautiful shot. Sphinx now trying to work the ball out. Nice give and go. Here they go. We got a 3-on-1. Three on one into the zone. Shot. Oh, and he missed. That was number 44, Christopher Drouin. But they still have control in the Bison's end. Now the Bison's trying to clear it out. Bison's chip it off the boards and down the ice it goes. On to number two, Dusty Grudeski. Ball gets cleared in behind the goal. Comes out now to number 11, that's Sebastian Moise. Clears it back into his own zone. Picked up there by Lesiege. Lesiege onto Moise. Moise takes a look, heads back to Lesiege.
Just a couple breakdowns in the defensive end for the Bisons. They're leaving the guys wide open on the red line.
Here they come again, working their way up the ice. That's number 26. Hugo Despien comes out in front. Here's a shot, score! Number 11, Sebastian Moise, on a perfect pass by Hugo Despien. But as you said, some defensive breakdowns in the zone there, Billy.
Yeah, that was it was quite a weak shot. I mean, I don't think anybody really got in the way of it. The goalie's seen it, but it's tough. Sometimes when you hit the ball on the top end, she can get a spin off the top and it just tricks the goalie. But just a couple guys that are missing. The guy streaking right up center, he's just walking in. They got two guys on one, so they're not playing their man as the way they should be.
Giving far too much space.
It looked like it got deflected there.
Yeah, off the heel and in the net. So now it's 3-0 for Sphinx over the Manitoba Bisons. 5:45 remaining here in the first period. And a big hole for the Bisons to try and get themselves out of. Here's a high stick.
Penalty.
Number 69, that would be Louis-Philippe Boutin. He's going to go off 2 minutes?
2 minutes for high stick, yeah. Any contact with the ball above the shoulders is an automatic 2-minute penalty.
So our first penalty of the game. Bisons would like to take advantage of this one with just over five minutes remaining here in the first period.
Yeah, they need some momentum to come their way, and hopefully they can shake around a power play goal. Even a little momentum where they see they be organized and playing their cycle through can really help change the game.
Here's the Bisons now on the power play, working the ball in around in the Sphinx zone. Here comes shot was a pass, shot on goal, nice save.
Using the boards for a bounce, tricks a lot of people.
Now Sphinx now just gonna work the ball out and they get it out of their zone. And on the third Sphinx goal, the official scoring was number 11, Sebastian Moise from 26, Hugo Despien at 6:01. Now Sphinx doing a great job on the penalty kill here, get the ball deep into the Bison zone. Bisons now trying to set it up, comes to number 10. That's Wayne Boxall. Boxall having a very difficult time getting anywhere there. Ball's gonna come back to Boxall. Boxall's gonna take his time working in over the line. Wayne Boxall puts it out now. Here comes a shot. Oh, that just sailed over the goal. Joey Ponchek comes back to Boxall. Boxall back to Ponchek. Ponchek back to Boxall. Boxall back to punt. Here's another shot. Goes just up over top of the goal. Boxall picks it up now.
Sphinx are playing a diamond shape defense. A lot of times you see a diamond shape, you see the one guy high out covering the point. Some guys, like the Phantoms and sometimes the Nationals as well and the rookies, they like to a tight box where there's two defenders closer to the net and two corners up on the point.
Comes to Boxall. Boxall now back up to punch it. Shot bouncing around in there, and it looks like Sphinx are going to get that ball out. And it goes back down the ice. That's going to do it for the power play. 2 seconds to go in that. Both teams back to even strength now.
Some might wonder why they don't just fire it down the ice. I mean, it's a penalty. They get the icing. But in Broomball, icing's called no matter what. Doesn't matter if you're shorthanded or on a power play or anything, it's called icing.
Yeah. Ball hits up into the rafters, and that's going to come back into the neutral zone closest to the Bison's goal. Got a good looking crowd here tonight.
Yeah, not too bad. We still got the Phantoms coming later on tonight for the main ticket. Lots of people excited to see that one, especially against the Aces top team. So
referee didn't like the way that one was dropped. A little infringement here, I guess, encroachment, I guess, by the guys closest to us. From the faceoff, Bisons win it, but it comes back to Sphinx. It's going to go, thought that was going out, but it didn't.
Hit the partition.
On to number 12, that's Reg Robideau. Robideau gets it over the line, but that's as far as they get with it. And here comes Sphinx. Sphinx trying to control that ball. Robideau picks it up. Good job by Robideau. Robideau now hangs onto it, looking for someone to play it to. Cleared back in by Sphinx. Ball's cleared on again, cut off by Sphinx. There's number 11. That's James Nolan. Nolan. Now there's number 12. That's Reg Robideau. Robideau trying to get out. Now here's another chance. And he's taken away. What a great opportunity for Sphinx to go up by four. But a great job there by number 7. That was Dallas Ouellette. Now Sphinx coming back into the zone. Ball goes free on the right side, picked up by the Bisons. Bisons now a nice long pass. Not quite enough speed to get through there. Here comes a shot. Bisons on the attack now, in behind the goal. That's number 16, Pierre Bees. Out front, shot, doesn't get through.
Nice block from the defense.
Sphinx now trying to make their way out, and great job by number 7, Dallas Ouellette. Ouellette's just going to clear it into the zone. He's got a teammate running onto it. That's number 14.
He's all alone. He's got no help getting a change out, and no one's really wanting to go help him.
Great job at keeping that in down there. There's number 10, Wayne Boxall, now with it. Boxall plays it back to his defense partner. He's going to try one. Down and blocked in front. Now here's Gauthier. Gauthier taking a look around. Back over to Boxall. Boxall's going to try one. Blocked right in front of him by number 13. That's Bilodeau. Now Sphinx trying to find some space. He's going to use his goalkeeper on this one. Now they're taking their time. We've got under a minute to go here in the first period. 3-0 Quebec Sphinx over the Manitoba Bisons. And the ball comes into the Bison zone. Sphinx looking to try and add another one before this period ends. They've got 40 seconds to do it. Taking their time, working it around. Ball's going to come in there to 91, Martineau. Martineau out front, shot scores! From his knees, stands back up, and he puts that one home.
Yep, he pinched in. I noticed that the Sphinx, every time they're in their zone, even if they don't have the ball, they're just running around. They're not waiting for a pass. They're trying to create opens. They're getting the Bisons confused, and that just happened. They left his man and left him all alone, even on his knees. Let him walk right in. You gotta stay on your man.
Great job. And that was number 20. That was Francois Lavigne scoring that goal. That'll be his second goal of the game. And a 4-0 lead now with 28 seconds remaining in the first period. Ball comes now. The Sphinx win the draw. That's number 17. That's Lesiege. Lesiege plays it over to his partner. Ball's now cut off by the Bisons. Bisons looking for some space here. It's number 12, Robideau. Robideau, a nice play on the number 13. That's Jeremy Saluski. Shot and a good grab. In the Sphinx goal. 6 seconds now remaining in this first period. And obviously been all Sphinx in this first period.
Yeah, it's been pretty one-sided. I'm not saying that the Bisons didn't get their chances, but Sphinx made it look pretty easy for some time. So.
Ball's going to be cleared all the way down the ice. And that buzzer signifies the end of the first period of play. And the teams are going to take about a 2 to 3 minute break here. We'll just go over the scoring again. As I said, Francois Lavigne with two goals tonight. The official scoring there, and Marino gets the assist. That'll be two assists for him tonight. Sebastian Moise opened the scoring at 6:01 from Hugo Despien, and at 7:54, Jonathan Richard Rake from Jan Marino to make it 2-0. And then Francois Levine would score 29 seconds, and then again at 9:36 to give the Quebec Sphinx a 4-0 lead over the Manitoba Bisons. I don't know what kind of discussion is going to be going on at the Manitoba bench right now.
I think they just got to calm down. Like, and you've seen it where some scores can get riding up and you get the emotions, but if you start thinking about the refs or the calls or the missed calls, but you're forgetting about trying to actually score a goal or trying to get the pass to the right place. Calm down, relax. I mean, it is 18-minute periods, and it's a long game. Four goals, if they get a quick two, they're back into the game.
Absolutely, yeah.
They just got to settle down.
You get one, the second one comes easier, and then you get two. Now you've got the other team thinking, you know, you get in their heads, and anything can happen. Like you said, 18 minutes to go in this one.
If they stay man-on-man in their end especially, it's tough because the Sphinx like to run around a lot, but if they stay man-on-man in their end, they should be all right. It's times when they just forget moments of lapse, and their player just goes right by, and the Sphinx picks it up like that and gets the ball to him.
All right, we're just about ready to start the second period. 4-0 lead.
New goalie in.
New goalkeeper in now for the Bisons.
It's a tough goal. It's never fun to be pulled.
No, absolutely not. And Bison's in control now. They get trying to work the ball into the Sphinx zone. Sphinx in control of it there. That's number 20, the two-goal scorer, Francois Levine. Levine is going to play it over. It's going to come back out. Oh, it goes right through everybody. Now on to number 12. That's Reg Robidoux. Robidoux plays it back now to Kennedy. Kennedy back to Robidoux. Robidoux working his way in front. Oh, he had himself in a great position, but number 11, Moise got his broom in the way and knocked the ball away from him. Now here's number 10. That's
it's a good fake.
Corville.
Watch those bounces behind the net, too. They bounce right to the other guy on the other side.
Bisons with some good pressure early on here. That's number 6. Dave Kennedy in behind the goal. He's got possession. Tries to get it out front. And the ball's going to be cleared out.
Nope.
Not over center. Good job by number 12, Robidoux.
Good hand eye, yep.
Otherwise, everybody has to clear the zone.
Long way from the corner all the way to the red line.
Now, here's number 12. That's Robidoux with it now. Robidoux's going to try one. Oh, that didn't miss by much.
It's closer than a lot of people thought it would be. I don't think the goalie think it was going to be that close.
No. Looked like it just took a little dip right
at the
end.
Yeah. Heavy air, I guess.
All right, we're going to have a face-off down to the right of goalkeeper. I believe that's... Is that Bert Stacey in there?
I guess he's been at the other end.
All right, from the draw, ball comes now and around the goal, Sphinx trapped into their own zone. Bison's really putting the pressure on them right now, trying to get back in this game.
Being physical, yep, that's the way they do it.
Now the ball comes out, Sphinx trying to work it out of their own zone. Honey, here we go. Getting set up in there, that's number 5, Robidoux. Robidoux with a shot, good save by the Sphinx goalkeeper. Ball now in Sphinx possession behind their own goal. Now they're gonna try and work the ball back out. Nice high ball coming down to number 69. That's Boulin. Boulin with a shot. Oh, it goes over the goal. That's the first offensive opportunity for the Sphinx in this second period. Now the Sphinx moving into the zone. That's number 69. That's Boulin. Boulin taking his time. Flips it in front. Nice shot. Scores. Wow. Great give and go there. And the player breaking in alone. And as you said, nobody was right on that guy.
No.
He was able to run in all by himself.
The Bison player went running towards him. And unlike hockey, you can't stop on a dime. So when he noticed that he's running the other way, it was a little too late.
Yeah, it was number 13. 13 on the Sphinx. That's Rouleau Bilodeau with his first of the game. That's going to make it a 5-0 lead with 15:28 remaining here in the second period.
It'll go to straight time with a 5-goal differential. If it gets to 8 goals, which sadly it might happen, mm-hmm. That's the game.
And they call the game.
Yeah,
at
they
that
call
point.
The game.
Now the Bisons working it around in their own zone, trying to get it out of there. Ball comes back now to number 11. That's James Nolan. Nolan plays it up the center. Now here come the Bisons working the ball in. There's number 13, Salutski. Salutski coming in. Oh, he tries to get one away. And he got it. Oh, nice opportunity there, but unable to get the shot away. Ball comes now to the Richard Rake. Into the zone pretty much all by himself as his teammates change. He was able to keep control of it for the moment. Now comes down into number 11, James Nolan. Nolan clears it around his own goal now onto number 13, James Salutski. Salutski takes a look. The ball comes now to number 6, Dave Kennedy. Kennedy at the line. That close to being offside. Sphinx are able to take control of the ball on their own end.
Oh, good steal, good steal.
Good steal. On to number 16, Pierre Biese. Takes a look, still working it around, looking for someone, loses his footing and goes down. Now here comes Sphinx. Sphinx moving back into the Bison zone. Oh, nobody there to get that pass from number 20, Francois Levine. Sphinx now with the ball back near the center line, keeping control of it. Comes back out now to number 11, Sebastian Moise. Moise is going to flip that one in. Here's a man in. Oh, didn't miss by much there. Gabriel Pequin was in there pretty much all by himself. Ball comes back out. Number 10, that's Wayne Boxall. Boxall's going to just get it into the Sphinx zone, and they're going to make changes. Ball back over now into the zone. Now nice pass right up the center. He's going up the middle. Unable to get the shot off. Great job by number 12. That was Reg Robideau. Great defensive effort to stop number 87.
Yeah, he was a quick player, but the tall, long reach of the Bison's players was able to get the ball away. He'll reach around the legs just to grab it.
Now Gradeski plays the ball back now to Reg Robideau. Robideau's just going to hammer it into the corner. Picked off there by the Sphinx. Sphinx comes out now, number 13. That's Bilodeau on to number 69, Boulin. Boulin, oh, avoids a body check there. Lucky stepped out of the way of that one. Here's number 12, Reg Robideau, now with the ball in his own end. 12:20 remaining here in the second period. 5-0 lead for the Quebec Sphinx over the Manitoba Bisons. Bisons in possession of the ball now, working it around, flips it into the zone. Number 13, that's Salutski. Salutski tries to get it out front, tip, and great coverage there by Sphinx, and they're just happy enough just to clear the ball out of their zone.
Yeah, the Sphinx seem to be playing a pretty good defense in their end. They're not pressuring them, they're just keeping them to the outside.
And the ball is cleared back out again. I just wonder if they're looking like maybe 5 goals is enough. And
yeah. I guess when you look at 5 goals and you look at the clock, whatever's on the clock is what amount of time's left. So.
Right.
No matter what.
Bisons now trying to get the ball out of their own zone. That's number 6. That's Dave Kennedy. Kennedy hanging on to it. Waiting for his teammates to set up here. Here's a run down the middle. Ball nice up. Nice try. Here comes a shot. Right on. Great save by the goalkeeper.
Yep. Seen it all the way. Just tough to handle. They're the Bisons are having a little, their defense are getting trapped back in there because they don't really have an option to get to their forwards. The forwards are being covered by the Sphinx pretty good. You got to keep moving. You got to jump off the boards, get a good flip up in the chase, or get a set up something where you can get it going. You're not going to get anything when your forwards are up with the blue lines.
Right, exactly. From the draw now, ball comes all the way back down into the Sphinx zone. That's number 7, Gabriel Pequin. Pequin plays it now over to number 26. That's Hugo Desbien. Desbien plays it into the zone. And that's going to be icing. 10-17. 10-15 remaining here 13, in the second 12, period. 12-11, we'll count it down.
Yeah, it's unfortunate, but you never want to see any games being mercy like this. You know the competitiveness is still there for everybody, but it gives you want to be better, whether it be next year or after something like that. But the game's getting stronger, and even in Manitoba, because I know they've always been there, so it's promising to what their future can hold too.
Ball's cleared back out now on to number 9, the Sam Massenson. And they try to clear it out, and they do, but it's right back into the Sphinx zone. Sphinx now just going to work it out. Now it's play up the middle. Plays it off to number 69, Boulin with a shot.
Just missed it.
Now here come the Bisons. Bisons trying to get one on the board. Bisons working in the zone. That's number 14, Gauthier. Shot doesn't get through. Sphinx doing a great job on defense. Just a smothering defense every time the Bisons get into their area. Got a 2-on-1 shaping up here now. 2-on-1. Oh, great job by number 12, Reg Robideau. Called his name many times here tonight. And it looks like got a Sphinx player that ended up face first into the goal. Referee's calling a penalty.
The Bisons are getting a penalty. I never seen what happened, but
no, I missed
if the
it
net
well.
Comes off that much, there was a little bit of force.
And it looked like he went in there head first, so. Well, there's nobody in the penalty box, so.
Oh, they're pointing to him now.
Oh, there is now. Some discussion as to.
Well, what do they put? They put 2 minutes or a 3-minute penalty for a straight time. I think it's just the 2 minutes penalty.
And it looks like it's going to be number 10 for the Bisons. That's Wayne Boxall. Boxall being one of the bright lights out there for the Bisons team so far in this game, but he'll be setting for 2 minutes or less. From the draw, won by Sphinx on to number 71. That's Bisons. Bisson taking his time into the zone. They're on the power play. Bisson, ball in the center, plays it over now to number 87. Goes back into the corner deep. Takes a look. We've got a man out front. 2 men out front now. We'll take a look around. Comes back to the point. And on to number 71, Bisson. Bisson's got it. Tries to get it through, unable to do so. And the ball is cleared out of the zone. That's number 87. That's Bilodeau. Bilodeau's just going to dump it into the zone. Ball comes Bisons in possession. Now they lose possession of it. The 69, Boulin. And a good save by the goalkeeper there. That's number 1, Connor Roy.
Yeah, with the straight time, you can get any whistle, and you can kill off a lot of time with the penalty, too.
That was a quick penalty. There's only 40 seconds left in it now. So.
Yeah.
Actually, I think they put it up before he even got in the box, and there was like 5 seconds off the clock.
Yeah, I'm not too sure what the ruling is with the straight time penalty. Sometimes, I know other tournaments, but they've been more recreational where they put a 3-minute penalty if it is a straight time. So.
And here comes Sphinx again. 5-0 lead here in the second period. 6:20 remaining in the game. Well in control of this one at this point. They're on the power play. Working the ball into the corner. Coming in front. Nice try. Oh. Nice little set play there that didn't quite work the way they wanted it to. Ball coming back out now to number 11. That's Moise. Moise tries one.
Back to even strength now.
And the ball's kept in. Whoa.
You gotta control your emotions, especially with the letter on.
Looked like that was number 10, Wayne Boxall, getting a little upset there for Manitoba. Oh, had it set up for a shot there. Didn't quite work the way he wanted it to. Bison's in control there. Now Houlette with the ball along the boards. He's going to clear it back off the boards. Looking for a teammate. Boxall takes his man into the boards. Ball's in behind the goal. Sphinx now working it out. 5:15 remaining in the game. 5-0 lead for the Quebec Sphinx over the Manitoba Bisons. There's number 12, Robidoux. Robidoux's going to flip it off the boards. Robidoux picks it up again. Gets it over the line, and it's cleared back again by Sphinx. I think Sphinx just seem to be happy just to play a defensive game.
Well, yeah, and they know they have to play another one, and they don't want to take too many chances, especially when a team who is obviously not happy with the way they're performing and frustration can take over. You don't want to get sucked into anything like that.
That's right, yes. You got one team heading in one direction, the other one heading in another, so. Ball comes back over now to number 16. That's Pierre Biasse.
Nice pass.
Cut off again by Sphinx. Now Manitoba doing their best to try and get one in here before this game ends. 4:15 now remaining in the game. Ball in. Here comes number 20. Ball's cleared back out. Nobody seems to really want control of this thing right now. James Nolan picks it up in his own zone. Too far for his teammate, but they're able to keep control of it. Here comes number 8, Ponsak. Ponsak now on to number 15, that's Darren Korf. Korf, defender gets in the way of that one. Battle along the boards, won by the Sphinx. Into the corners, number 71, Martin Bisson. Over to Moise. Moise is being battled along the boards hard there by number 6. Had Dave Kennedy in there.
Good for the ref to just blow the whistle, because I've seen it before where you go in there innocently and the ball just gets stuck and everybody starts shoving each other.
That's right. Yeah, nothing good comes out of it when you're that close together along the boards.
The refs here at this tournament, even at the rec center and up the Bay Shore, have been incredible. I mean, they are away from home. I'm local, but these guys are like 6-7 hours at the very minimum. We have a girl ref from the Northwest Territories.
Wow.
She's very small, but she knows how to call them, even with the big times.
Bison's now with some pressure on in the zone. 2:45 remaining in the game. Bison's trying to get at least one here before the final buzzer. Sphinx doing a great job at keeping them to the outside. Here comes a shot in.
Nice
ball's
pressure,
loose.
Nice pressure.
It's going to be a penalty. Interference call, it looks like. Looks like it might be going against the Bisons.
I wonder if he crossed into the crease and hit the goalie. Oh, no, it is Sphinx. Oh.
Yeah, Sphinx are taking the penalty here.
Oh, maybe he bumped him into the goalie. Maybe that was it.
That'll be number 55. That's Bernard Peltier.
Well, I'm hoping the Bisons get one here. I mean, you never want to leave a game getting beaten like this.
And Sphinx are going to take control of that ball and try and get it out, and they can't. Here's number 10. That's Boxall. Boxall plays it on to Robidoux. Robidoux gets it back over to Boxall. Boxall plays it down, back to Boxall. Boxall looked like he was going to try one. Out to Robidoux. Number 6, that's Kennedy. Back to Robidoux. Ball's just cleared away by the goalkeeper. And Bisons are able to keep control of it. Comes back now to Robidoux. Robidoux tries one. Oh, goes up over top of the goal. Little spinorama shot there.
Little trick shot. You can be very talented if you can pull that off. If you can shoot on anyway.
The ball's going to come all the way back down. 1 minute remaining in this game. 5-0 lead for the Quebec Sphinx.
With 1 minute left, I might even pull the goal. Even you're down 5-0, but better if they got it deeper. But it's not as if the Sphinx are pressuring you, so you can might as well use as many as you can.
That's right.
When goal differential is that important.
That's maybe why, too, the Sphinx were back in the defensive mold to try not to allow any goals, mm-hmm. just in case that comes into play in a tiebreaker.
Yeah.
And the Bisons, we got 24 seconds remaining here. Bisons on the attack, trying to get one before it's done. Comes back out to number 8. That's Ponsak, tries one. Ball's in behind the goal. Tries it out front, back out to Ponsak, shot. Oh, goes over the net. Good job in there by number 5. That was Robidoux. Robidoux's possession shot. The final buzzer goes, and that's the end of this one. The Quebec Sphinx win by a score of 5-0 over the Manitoba Bisons. I would imagine now that I think the Sphinx now on the tournament are 5-1.
I believe so. I don't know who they lost to, but whoever they lost to is probably a pretty good team. So, but you know what? The Sphinx, they had a really slow first half, but getting into the second period, they got stronger. They held the ball a bit in their end. Sphinx was a little laid back on the defense, but you could see when they were moving, the Bisons were moving in their end sometimes to get that ball out. Just a little bit more running, but it's tough when you got a team like the Sphinx who just constantly runs.
Absolutely, and they're in a first place tie now, I believe, with Aces, or they might be ahead of Aces at this point.
At this point, I think the Aces are still undefeated. So.
Yeah, Aces play later on tonight. So getting ready for the most valuable player awards. And it looks like number 12, Reg Robidoux for the Bisons is going to win the MVP for them. For the Sphinx, can't quite see his number at this point. I didn't hear the call, so. And that was number 11. That was Sebastian Moise picking up the most valuable player award for the Quebec Sphinx. So, not a great game for the Bisons, not a great game for them, but the Sphinx did exactly what they needed to do in order to keep in pace with the other Quebec counterparts, the Quebec Aces, and a possible chance at a tie for first place.
Yeah, we'll see if how the Aces do tonight against the Phantoms, but the Bisons, I mean, you can't let the score determine your success. I mean, it was unfortunate that it was 5-0, but the Bisons, they knew they were the underdogs coming in, and they gave it heart, and they play hard all the way till the end. They really did. They kept shooting, they kept fighting, so give them props for that. But the Sphinx is a strong team, Quebec team.
Absolutely.
They play all year round, or not all year round, but they play a lot in Quebec, like Quebec. Quebec City is a lot bigger than the prairies of Manitoba,
right.
The population. So,
and a lot colder here.
A lot colder, yeah.
Probably have ice all year long.
Maybe. Get some outdoor rinks, too. But
No offense, Quebec's a beautiful city.
It's the most beautiful city in North America. I love it there. You take pride, like, in the small communities for Broomball. I mean, Kilsyth, 500 people against Ottawa. Ottawa, 500,000, and it's not like the people in Ottawa, on the Ottawa team, are from Ottawa. It's the valley, from north to south, all the way down. So that's pretty good for when we compete against them.
Absolutely, absolutely. All right, the 2016 Canadian Senior Broomball Championships, game one of three is out of the way. Quebec Sphinx, as you see on the on your screen, 5-0 winners over the Manitoba Bisons. Up next, a great game, should be a great game, between the Ottawa Nationals and last year's champion, Palmerston Rookies. I'm Rob Leonard. And for Bobby Nickel, we're going to take...
Billy Nickel.
Sorry?
Billy Nickel.
Billy Nickel. Billy Nickel,
yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah, no, that's, I got used to that.
Billy, Bobby, and Bob's the insurance guy.
Yeah, Bob's my All brother, right. actually.
Bob's your uncle. So.
Oh, my brother. My brother.
Okay. All right, we're going to take a short break, and we'll be right back with the second game of three tonight.
What kind of...